Yo, yo, what's going on, everyone? We are here, another episode of Therapy Without a Degree. You guys already know Joe Fucarino is here. We got Mr. Zane in the building.
How's it going, brother?
There he is. But it's a little different, right? We're at a different set today.
Yeah.
Whole different vibes. We are today at the Lodi Police Headquarters in Lodi, New Jersey. Very special episode. Today we're doing something a little different.
Right.
Right? So we're doing a takeover. We have Anthony Mobilio and Vinnie Martin taking over the podcast, right, for a very special interview. This is going to be really cool. I'm super excited. And, yeah, man, Zane, this is going to be fun. You ready for this?
Absolutely.
All right, sounds good. And if any one of you guys out there ever want to do this as well, if you guys ever want to take over a podcast, you guys want to be guest co-hosts, let us know. We would love to do this to highlight special individuals that you guys know.
So, and we also have internships, so anybody who wants to know how media works as well as podcasts, definitely contact us, and we're going to help you out from beginning to end.
Yes, let's do it. But let's just jump right into this interview. Let's make some magic happen. We'll see y'all soon.
Hey, Lodi residents and friends of social media, it's Lieutenant Mobilio here from the Lodi Police Department, and I am joined today by retired Detective Vincent Martin and Lodi Borough Councilman Vincent Martin and New Jersey State Champion Lodi High School Junior Leanna Mercado. Welcome, everybody.
Thanks, Hi. Anthony.
Thank you.
So we have Lee here today, and we want to congratulate her on her wrestling championship, state championship at weight 107. And we just want to talk a little bit about how you got into wrestling and all the things that you did to accomplish becoming a state champ, because that is definitely no easy task. So we want to talk to you again. We want to congratulate you, and we want to talk to you about how you got to become a state champ.
Thank you.
Yeah. So let's just start off again, Leanna. Let's start off with what it's a unique sport, right? We talked about it. I coached wrestling for a long time. Lieutenant Mobilio's son wrestled for the high school, so we're familiar with the sport. Mm-hmm. Female wrestling has become very popular now.
It is.
So, but what got you into the sport?
So, first, around, I want to say, like, fourth grade, I started doing mixed martial arts and jiu-jitsu. So, I did that for a couple of years. And then, once I moved to Lodi, my dad put me in wrestling for Lodi Rec to get my takedowns better. And so, after that, we kind of just, like, stuck with wrestling.
So, you kind of fell in love with the sport.
Yeah.
You need to fall in love with the sport in order, yes, to keep wrestling. So that's great. So you wrestle for a Lodi Rec program,
mm-hmm,
through eighth grade.
Yes.
And then I know the first 2 years you went to an academy school, correct?
So I went to the academy my sophomore year at Scorpions.
Okay. And then you came back into Lodi, mm-hmm, which made you eligible. So I just want people to know she's in a good way, she's a beast on the mat.
Yeah.
And most likely, being at the academy last year, you're not eligible to wrestle for the state tournament
because, yeah,
it's not sanctioned by the state. But chances are she would have placed, if not won the whole thing last year too, especially, yes, the way you look this year. So after the academy, you decided to come back to Lodi. So,
yeah,
talk a little bit about being in the wrestling room. I know there's we combine with Immaculate Conception High, mm-hmm, School. So between the Lodi girls and the Immaculate Conception girls, probably 10 to 12 girls in the,
yeah,
wrestling room.
Yeah.
So take us a little through, how is that for those, maybe other female wrestlers or somebody who might be thinking about getting into the sport, kind of combining with there being 12 females in the wrestling room, 12, the boys are in the wrestling room, but the camaraderie between everybody in the wrestling room.
So it was nice to see a whole bunch more girls in there because comparing to my freshman year, there really wasn't anyone. I would say maybe one other girl. So it was nice to see more girls and just like boys and girls in the same room working together and just all putting in the same work.
Awesome. So just to know that, and I'll get to you saying. So Leanna also was undefeated against the boys this year when she wrestled in the varsity lineup.
Good for you. Good for you. So speaking of the boys, now when you were in the rec program, there was just, you were wrestling boys and girls, correct? I mean, it wasn't just a girls' league and a boys' league in the rec program. Is that correct?
In the rec program, there really wasn't that many girls. I would say I was like the only girl and maybe one other girl occasionally. And so I was really wrestling against boys.
And how did you feel at that time? And how did you do against the boys?
Back then, during rec days, I wasn't really good, but mentally, I was like tough.
Right.
Like I never really gave up,
mm-hmm.
and so I just always had that fight in me.
So when you started wrestling in high school, you never wrestled boys in high school? It was always a girls' division and a boys' division.
So
in high
freshman
school?
Year, it was really only girls. I only wrestled girls, and then. Sophomore year, I went to the academy. Mm-hmm. So then this year was when I really got to wrestle boys.
Oh, you wrestled boys this year?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. So in the varsity lineup, yeah. in the tournament, she was in the female tournament,
mm-hmm. right?
Girls tournament. But during the season, in dual meets, in dual matches, she was in the lineup.
Oh, you did?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. That I
and she was undefeated.
Oh, I wasn't aware.
So watch out.
Very good, Lynn. Very good. Very good.
So obviously, again, being knowing the sport, right? Mm-hmm. To wrestle at your level, obviously you train at a club.
Yes.
So what are you still at Scorpions, or do you train at a couple other clubs?
Scorpions.
Yes. Good, okay. All right, now how often do you go to Scorpions Club?
So Scorpions has classes Tuesdays and Thursdays and Sundays. So they'll usually have two classes Tuesdays and Thursdays. So I'll do the first class, and then I'll stay for the high school class. Tuesdays and Thursdays.
Okay. And that's in season and out of season? I know times mm-hmm. change sometimes in season because they accommodate the wrestling schedule.
Yeah, I wrestle all year round.
And that's all year round, mm-hmm. obviously. Talk a little bit about how jiu-jitsu
mm-hmm.
complements wrestling. And I'm sure wrestling complements jiu-jitsu in a way, but how does jiu-jitsu complement you in wrestling?
Well, they're both combat sports, so mentally, like, as a young girl, I feel like it definitely, like, I wasn't like most little girls. Like, I was a fighter. So, yeah.
Good. All right.
Well, to be in the spot that you have to be a fighter.
Yes.
I mean, even though wrestling is a team sport, mm-hmm. it's still an individual accomplishment.
Definitely.
That you're wrestling out there. It's you and you're defending or you're wrestling at the time. So even though it's a team sport, it's still you against someone else.
Yes.
And leading up to the state championship, what were the feelings that you were going through in that day when you knew that, that, you know, this is it? You know, what were the feelings that and the emotions you were going through?
I would say that I was really excited but also nervous because my coach Omar Feliciano mm-hmm. at my Scorpions Club, he always tells me that you could do everything right leading up to that point, but still that, like, not winning is guaranteed. So I always had that in the back of my mind.
Right.
Even though I feel like I already won this match last year throughout everything that I went through. That was still in the back of my mind. It was excitement, but like anxiousness. But when I was getting called up to like run into the mat, it was just focus.
Right.
Complete focus.
You get kind of like,
yeah.
I guess you
tunnel
get tunnel vision.
Vision
and
yeah.
you're ready to go. And
yeah.
Now, did you enter jiu-jitsu tournaments too when you were younger? Or?
Yeah.
So mm-hmm. so you had a little tournament experience before you got into the wrestling
yeah.
aspect. So talk a little bit about, before I get into like, how you balance academics and wrestling.
Mm-hmm.
So just, actually, let me go there first. I'll save the big one for last. So
okay.
Talk to us about academics, high school practice,
mm-hmm.
and then club practice. Because people realize you're going to club practice, you're not missing high school practice.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You're still going to high school practice.
Mm-hmm.
Then you're going to club practice. And then you're doing homework and hopefully studying
yeah.
for a test and getting up to be in school on time. I mean, it's a commitment. And you know, and that's probably where jiu-jitsu and having that disciplined mind
mm-hmm.
helps. But talk
yeah.
a little bit about balancing academics and your training.
It definitely does take discipline. Sometimes I do have lazy days, I will admit. But I try and stay on top of my homework and studying and all that as much as I can.
Good. Now, your aspirations to wrestle in college?
Yes.
You have any place in mind?
I really am thinking about going to East Charlesburg University.
Okay. Oh. My daughter went for
really?
A semester. Yeah.
Yeah.
She did.
Yeah,
sorry.
Just a quick question mm-hmm. on as a female now. As I know a lot of that, with my son, cutting weight,
mm-hmm.
making weight, that's a big part of wrestling and,
yeah.
and being ready to go. Did you have that problem with maintaining your weight, or is it you just that's your size and your weight really wasn't a big problem for you and cutting weight? And
so my weight wasn't really a problem. I usually walk around 112, so cutting down, to get to 107, but then it eventually went up to 109. It really wasn't anything.
Wasn't hard for you to maintain that weight of 107?
No, not really.
Was that always? What was the weights like as you came through? I mean, was this the heaviest weight that you wrestled for the state champ?
Like you mean this year?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the weight that I stayed at. Previous years, like my freshman year and sophomore year. No, not my sophomore year. Freshman year, I was like 114.
Okay.
Yeah.
So even that, really, I mean, it's only 7 pound difference. So really, it is okay. So 107 is basically.
And you actually answered the question. I was going to ask if the girls got the 2 pound allowance too. They do. Good. Mm-hmm. So I guess so. Last year, obviously, you were at the academy, mm-hmm. so you didn't experience the girls' tournament last year, which right. the region tournament, which mm-hmm. you got to win or qualify to get to the States, was done at Elizabeth.
Yeah.
And then they kept everything at Elizabeth, I believe. This year, I think they went up to Pittsburgh.
Pittsburgh, yeah.
So when the way they did it this year, which was great, was they wrestled the state tournament, right, mm-hmm. from third place to eighth place,
yes.
complete. Mm-hmm. The two finalists didn't wrestle on that day. They got to go to wrestle at Boardwalk Hall in Atlantic City. Mm-hmm. And I thought the state did it great. They didn't shortchange the girls. They put the girls on before the boys. Like there was a crowd there.
Yeah.
It was, you know, so talk about, listen, we've all been in Lodi High School gym. I've been to Elizabeth. I've been to other tournaments. Boardwalk Hall.
Yeah.
You know, how did that feel? Again, with people in the audience. Mm-hmm. It wasn't like they put you on 8 o'clock in the morning and nobody was out there. It was crowded. It was a real nice crowd for the girls.
Yeah, it definitely was crowded, but I've been to Fargo, which is a national tournament, right. and the arena's huge. Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, I've been to those kind of tournaments, so it wasn't really anything new, but the experience, like the energy there, like you could feel it.
Right.
You could feel it.
So then that was a plus, right?
Mm-hmm.
Wrestling in Fargo and the Beast and all those in front of big crowds makes you, you know, I guess a little more comfortable.
Yes.
But then again, I guess, say when the bright lights come on, mm-hmm. you're zoned,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, I was.
Like you don't know if there's 10 people in the audience or if there's 3,000. Mm-hmm. I mean, you're zoned.
Yeah.
Ready to go.
So that was good. So what will you do now off season leading up to? Will you take a break? Maybe not so much with training. So you won't take a break training.
No.
Will you take a break tournament-wise for a little while before you get into competition again, let's say?
Until high school season starts again?
Yeah, well, I mean, I know you'll wrestle before high school season.
Yeah.
I imagine you'll kick into freestyle now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
so when
started.
When's that? As far as practice, we already started. But when's your tournament?
Well, I'm trying to make the Puerto Rican national team. Right. So that's April 29th, I'm pretty sure.
Okay.
But before that, I have USA Nationals.
Okay. And that's another thing, everybody. So we're trying to make the Puerto Rican national team. There's been a GoFundMe page started. I know I spread it on my social media.
Thank you.
And I think a couple other people have. So we'll see that. But you're supporting a Lodi girl. You're supporting a resident, somebody who really cares about the sport and is doing something unique. Because, again, at least out in this part, Eastern New Jersey, New York, female wrestling is popular, but not popular as other places.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's an Olympic sport for those who don't know. So give me some aspirations there.
I definitely want to make the Puerto Rican national team and try and wrestle in the Olympics. So I would have to place, I'm pretty sure, for U20 or U17.
Okay.
No, U20.
So how old are you now?
I am 16.
So you're 16.
Mm-hmm.
So if you wrestle in the freestyle this summer, it'll be you. It's not you.
I'm doing U17 and U20.
Right? Mm-hmm. And U20. Okay.
Yeah.
And how did you get approached to join or even to try to compete for the Puerto Rican national team?
So one of the coaches that my dad has connections to, he actually like put us in line, the East Charlesburg coach.
Okay.
So, yeah, he knows a couple of people down there. So he's kind of like lining it all up for me.
Good.
Right, so I'm going to give you an opportunity to shout out a couple of people.
Yes.
Whoever you want to shout out. Like your training partners, mm-hmm. maybe. Your coaches. I know you mentioned Omar already.
Mm-hmm.
And I kind of know Omar. You might not remember, but like I said, my brother-in-law was a wrestling coach for 28 years. Mm-hmm. So we had guys that wrestled at Scorpions. Coach, take a couple minutes to shout out who you want to shout out. Because, listen, again, it takes a good drill partner. Yes. It takes good drill partners, not only in the high school room, but good drill partners at Scorpions. Mm-hmm. You know, somebody to push you.
Yes.
Doesn't pay if you're just going to go beat everybody up. You're not mm-hmm. going to get better. Yep. So go ahead. The mic's yours.
I hope I don't forget anyone.
Well, I'm not putting you on spot, but so I'll maybe make it easier for you. So in the high school, you drill with somebody basically all the time?
So in high school, I'm drilling with Omar Asfor and Malik Asfor.
Okay, the brothers.
Yes.
103 and 107. No, 113. No.
Yeah, and 107.
And 107. Mm-hmm. I forgot high school starts a little bit. So you train with the brothers in the room.
Yep.
Which is great. And both great wrestlers, both had great careers. Omar battled some injuries this year, but he's a warrior. Malik mm-hmm. battled some injuries, but they're warriors, so that's good. And then at the club?
So at the club, I practice with James McGinty, Sebastian Crystal, Charlie Wiley, Kara Pimpkins, Adrian DeJesus, Gino Shanina, and...
I'm putting you on the spot, but yeah.
And I think that's it, I'm pretty okay. sure, yeah.
So talk a little bit about Coach Favre and Coach J-Rod, and how they balance the IC girls that mm-hmm. come into the room, which I imagine works, and how they balance the coaching.
You know, they were always on top of their stuff. I came back to Lodi... really putting my trust in them, and they just didn't fail. Like, they were everything that I needed, they did for me. They were always supportive ever since my freshman year. Like, leaving and coming back, they were just still the same. So, great. I appreciate them.
And then, obviously, your biggest supporters.
Yeah.
Right? Why don't you mention them?
My dad and my mom. My dad literally, like, ever since I did jiu-jitsu, he's just always been there. He does everything. Love you.
Well, listen, in any extracurricular activity that anybody does, mm-hmm. you know, whether it's athletics, whether it's band, whether it's drama, schoolwork, just everyday life, right? You need the support of your parents. This sport is special, right? Because you don't drive yet, right? So you gotta get to the academy. Yeah. You gotta get to the club at night now. There's a lot that goes on. You got to get to Fargo. You got to get to the Beast. Well, the Beast is a high school event, but you got to get to those tournaments.
And North Carolina. And you drove like six, what was it, 6 or 8 hours?
Yeah, so all the way over there. The support system is good.
Yes.
Right. So, Lee, we talked about Coach Favre and Coach J-Rod. Mm-hmm. Why don't we mention some of your club coaches?
So, I would like to shout out Jose DeJesus, Gabe Roman, Craig Mano, and Omar Feliciano.
And they're at Scorpions.
Yes, in Fairfield.
Again, we want to just thank you very much for coming in. Lodi, just support Lee and everything that she does.
Thank you.
There is a GoFundMe page out there, correct, for the Puerto Rican mm-hmm. national team. Again, we want to say congratulations to you.
Yes,
thank
congratulations.
You,
thanks for having me.
Councilman Martin.
Thanks, New Jersey Media.
Thank you,
Joe and Zane.
Joe,
thank you, guys.
And everybody.
Appreciate
thank
it.
Thank you to your parents for bringing you here today.
Yeah.
So, Lodi. Let's just keep her in our thoughts and prayers. Mm-hmm. God bless you all out there, and we'll see you again. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, everybody.
Thank you.
What's going on, guys? So we just wrapped up a super cool interview here at the Lodi Police Headquarters with a very special guest. Can you tell them who you are? Because you're a big thing out here.
My name is Leanne Mercado, and I'm the state champ for Lodi for 107.
State champ. You guys heard it right. State champ. And you got something really cool out there. You got a fundraiser?
Yes, I do. So that's actually to help me get to wrestle at Puerto Rico for the women's national team.
Okay, let's go. When is it? When's the event?
So this is April 29th.
Okay, so that means people got to donate, share it now, and push it, right?
Yeah, we're almost there.
For real. So anything, whatever you could donate $1. I know you guys have it, $1, $10, $100. Even if you can't actually donate physical money, maybe you could share it.
Yeah.
Right? You could share it to somebody else and maybe they could help, right? Because this is something that's powerful. How old are you?
I'm 16.
And you out here just taking names.
Yes.
Hey, keep doing what you're doing.
Thank you.
Keep killing it. Don't stop no matter what happens because life is going to life. But just keep fighting just like you're doing.
Yes.
All right. And to help her to keep fighting, we really need your support. All right. Really need your support to help share this fundraiser, to keep pushing this and just to take this to the next level. And I mean, just to visit Puerto Rico.
Yes.
That's fine. Right? All right, guys. Donate.
Thank you.
Get off your knees and drive forward. Yes. Knee up the butt.
Chop that side.
Forward, forward!
Slide through it. Yes, keep
working there. Chop, get to a wrist. Good. Drive forward.
Keep working. Keep working. She's getting tired. Keep working.
Keep digging that back foot.
Head up. Head up. Everybody try.
Hey, take that.
Come to the other side. Come to the other side. Come to the right. Pull it through her legs now. Drive forward. You're good.
Yo,
you're good.
Keep pressing it.
Hey, B, you're fine.
Watch the headlock.
Explode here. Explode. Explode off the mat. Explode. All the way up. Stay on your feet. Stay on your feet.
Stay on your feet. Stay on your feet.
Stay on your feet. Stay on your feet. Good job. Motion. Get your feet moving. Hey.
Yo.
She reaches up. Take that double leg.
We don't need to tell her. Look at me. Please.
She's got to try to hit a miracle shot. Come on.
Level change here. Motion.
Yes.
Yo, let's end it here, bro.
Drive forward, keep her on the mat. Forward, mama, drive that back foot. Drive that back foot. Use your right leg, drive. Use your right foot, drive forward. Forward, forward, forward. Good. Keep driving forward.
Please drive.
On your toes, please.
Push there.
Keep driving, keep her on her head. Yeah, take your time here. Cover, 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 cover. Cover. Cover, she's got to be flat. Head up.
No, she's
hey,
25, finish on top. 25. Top, my side.
Use
that. Drive, keep driving. Yes, pull it through a line. Pull it through a line.
Good job.
Omar.
Good job.
Love you, man.